Welcome to Stansted Airport. Thanks for joining me on the stream. I have a feeling there's not going to be too many joining me on the stream. But there might be a few who will watch it on YouTube afterwards. Oh, Sylvia has a blank screen on the left. Says I am now live, so I haven't got a blank screen on the left. So, hopefully it's working. Hopefully it's working for you, Sylvia, at least. Perhaps you can give me a thumbs up or something. You should be getting some video by now. Anything happening? Ah, no, she's got something. Is it working okay? I'm going to come off pause so that we can at least hear some noise from the game. Works alright now. I can see you in the cockpit. Okay, that's good. Anyway, here we are at London Stansted, and we're flying the default 737 Ryanair livery, and we're going to be going to Frankfurt Hahn. This is a journey that I make, I have been making for years, every few weeks. But just lately I've actually been flying to Luxembourg, but I've been doing this journey from Stansted to Hahn for years. Got to be probably about 7 years. So it's a default 737, so not everything is modelled in it. A few of the systems actually aren't modelled, but lots of the stuff actually works, so keeps me busy. I've got a few little extras as well in the cockpit that I've downloaded. So, first things first, I'm just going to check the parking brake is set. Got this parking brake is set on. And we're going to turn on battery. So I've got some power coming in. Let's see what we're going to do. I'm going to turn on the auxiliary power unit. First thing that I'm going to do is to actually mute the radio, because that'll get on my nerves actually with that going all the time. So I'll start the auxiliary power unit here, and the generator is on, so we can enable us to actually start the engines. Okay, Sylvia said it's working good, so that's okay. Okay, so we can actually set some of the autopilot up now. We can set the speed here in the speed bug. I'm actually going to set it using a Cytec panel, but you can just click on this and set it anyway. I've got a Cytec panel, which makes things a little bit easier. So I'm going to set 250 knots. 250 knots is going to be a sort of climb out speed. So I've set that, 240, 250 knots. Make sure the auto throttle is armed. What else? What we can do now, we can actually get clearance. Oh, what I want to do is turn on this FMC, which is the flight management computer, which is something I've just downloaded. I don't really know how it works, so I'm not going to be using that. I'm going to be using a default FSX flight plan, which I downloaded, which is virtually the same route, same waypoints as the actual flight that I make for real. That's a GPS flight plan, so I put the little switch down to GPS. Next job, I'm going to contact Stansted Ground to get some clearance. Request IFR clearance.
Stansted Ground, Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot Romeo 758, ready to copy IFR clearance to Hahn. Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot Romeo 758 is cleared to Hahn Airport. Just file. Fly runway heading, climb and maintain 13,000. Departure frequency is 120.625. Squawk 7022.
Let's read that
Boeing,
back.
Romeo Yankee Foxtrot Romeo 758. Cleared on airport as filed. Fly runway heading, climb and maintain 13,000. Departure on 120.625. Squawk 7022.
Boeing 7.
contact ground on 121.725.
Okay, so I can put 13,000 feet into the heading bug here. Sorry, the altitude bug. Been cleared to 13,000. Again, I'm going to input it in using my little panel down here. Make it a little bit easier rather than clicking on the mouse. So I'm going to put 13,000 feet in. And vertical speed as well has got to be sorted. So we'll put 1900 feet per second. So I can click the altitude hold switch, ready for the autopilot to come in. It says fly runway heading, so we can put the runway heading in as well, which I know the way the wind's blowing, so we can just put the heading in. This is going to be about that. We can click the heading hold switch, put that on. So that's the autopilot sort of set up. Right, next job. We can put on some lights. We certainly need the rotating beacon. That needs to be on because I'm going to start to move in a minute. We can put on the no smoking and fasten seat belts. So there it is. We're all ready for pushback now. This airport is by UK2000. It is actually payware, but it's very, very realistic. The general scenery I'm going to be using is just the default FSX scenery, apart from the airports. And the airports are really, really great. This one is especially good. Okay, so back in the cockpit. I'm now going to request taxi.
Stansted round, Boeing, Romeo, Yankee, Foxtrot, Romeo 758 with Delta, ready to taxi IFR. Boeing, Romeo, Yankee, Foxtrot, Romeo 758, taxi to and hold short of runway 22, using taxiway Charlie Sierra. Contact tower on 125.55 when ready.
Okay, so I've been told I can taxi, so I'll acknowledge that.
Taxiing hold short runway 22 via taxiway Charlie Sierra, Boeing 758.
Okay, so here we go. We're going to push back now. So, push the appropriate key and make sure that the parking brake is off. And now we're being pushed back. On this side, there's normally lots more EasyJet planes. Seems to be the EasyJet ones are here, and the Ryanair ones are on the other side, in the direction that we're actually pushing back to. So we put some other lights on now as well. This is an evening flight, so it's going to start off fairly light, and the sun should set as we're actually doing the flight. Flight should be about an hour, take about an hour to get to Frankfurt Hahn. So, let's push back. I'll put the parking brake back on. Starting up the engines now, so what I'll do, I'll actually move this. There's the engine display. Move that over so I can see that a little bit better over here. And so we can think about starting the engines. What I'm going to do, I'm going to press the starter for engine 2, starting engine 2 first, then I'm going to pull the fuel cutoff control switch. I'm actually going to introduce fuel into the engine. When the engine is turning, using N2, which is the core engine speed, a percentage of that's got to be about 20%, then I can start. So I'm going to hit this starter switch on number 2. I can watch N2 come up here. When it hits about 20, I'm going to raise the starter The control switch. Introduce fuel. There we go. So that seems to start okay. Just wait for the engine to stabilize. It's okay. So I'm going to turn off the fuel, starter switch for number two. Do the same for engine number one. So the starter switch goes on. I'm looking for N2 of about 20%. So the N2 is rising on number one. And there we go. Engine number two has started. Let's wait for those to stabilize. And we can turn off the starter switch. Turn off the auxiliary power unit as well. Don't need that anymore. The auxiliary power unit is a little jet engine in the back of the tail of the plane. It's needed to start the engines and to supply power when the engines aren't running. But now we can turn the APU off and turn the APU generator off as well. Turn the generators on for engine 1 and engine 2. Should have done that before I turned the APU off. So now we're getting power from the engines now. So we can start to taxi. Next thing to do is put the flaps down for takeoff. So flaps 5. So the flaps are set for takeoff. Parking brake is coming off. And we can now taxi out to the runway. As I say, not all systems are modelled on here, so this is the sort of 737 to have a go on if you're sort of a beginner to intermediate flight simmer. Really, there is aircraft to download that every single swish and every single system works. I have got some aircraft that do that, but not the actual 737. So. And it's got to be a Ryanair 737 flying from Hahn, isn't it? So we're taxiing out to the runway. What we must do as well reactivate the radio there. Well, we've been told to contact the tower, haven't we? Yeah. Tune Stansted tower, but we can contact the tower when we get a little bit nearer the actual runway itself. Okay, here we are. Plane coming in there. to land. So I can contact the tower now. Request takeoff clearance.
Stansted Tower, Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758, ready to go. Runway 22, IFR to on Niner Jude 74, exit runway when able. Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758, hold short, runway 22.
I'm told to hold short.
Hold short, runway 22, Boeing 758.
Probably got to wait for that other Ryanair to clear the runway. So have a quick look, make sure everything's set.
Stansted Tower 3633 plus 10 miles northeast inbound visual, runway 22 approach.
Niner 274, contact ground on 121.725. Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758, clear for takeoff, runway 22.
Okay, I've been cleared for...
Stansted Tower, fly straight in, runway 22, altimeter 2983.
I've been cleared for takeoff. There's obviously another plane coming in as well, so I guess I shouldn't hang around too long. Says the other plane that's coming in to land. It's about 10 miles away. The air traffic control is a little bit iffy. But I enjoy using it. It's not perfect. Okay, so we're ready to take off. Just make sure everything's selected. We've got 250 knots in on the auto throttle, 13,000 feet heading, runway head in. So everything should be good. Flaps are set, so we can go. So that's V1 and rotate. It's positive rate of climb. So we can bring the gear up. And the carriage is up. We can just click the speed hold switch now. And we can bring the flaps in. Speed is 235.
Boeing 758, did you copy? 309.
Yes, I did copy. I've been handed over now to another controller.
737 on final. 120.625 for Boeing 758.
Clear to land. Runway 22309 or 6.
Right, tune SX departure now.
SX departure, Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758 is at 2,100, climbing 13,000.
Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758 SX departure, roger, altimeter 2983, Boeing 758, turn left, heading 110, climb and maintain 13,000.
Right, put the autopilot on now.
110, climb and maintain 13,000, Boeing 758.
I'm told to turn left to 110. So we'll do a left turn. Flaps up. Yeah, flaps are up. Flaps are up. So we've basically taken off in the wrong direction, so we've got to do a full turn to double back now. I'm still following air traffic control at the moment. So we can take off some of these lights. Leave the seatbelt sign on just for a minute. Okay, got to contact Southend approach now.
130.775, Boeing 758. Southend approach, Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758 is at 8,000, climbing 13,000. Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758, Southend approach, Roger, altimeter 2983. Boeing 758, contact London Center on 118.475.
Thanks, co-pilot, saying it's a nice view.
Going to 118.475, Boeing 758.
Right, it's tuning in London Center now. Contact London.
London Center, Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758 is at 900,800, climbing 13,000.
Boeing, Romeo, Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758, London Center, Roger. Altimeter 2983.
I'm gonna be vectored probably one more time, and then usually they tell you to use your own navigation.
467. Descend and maintain flight level 220.
Descend and maintain flight level 220. Monarch 467.
Coming over to the Thames Estuary now, River Thames Estuary there. Okay, you can tow to my head into 135, which I'm going to do. We'll put that into the autopilot. And it now says proceed on course. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to take it off heading.
758, turn right heading 135, proceed on course. Climb and maintain flight level 190.4154.
Clear to 190 as well.
Climb and maintain flight level 230.4154.
Turn right heading 135, proceed on course, climb and maintain flight level 190, Boeing 758.
So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to take it off heading hold, and I'm going to put it onto nav hold. The nav hold switch will then enable the flight computer to follow the waypoints that have been set in for this particular journey. So heading select comes off. And nav hold switch comes on, so now the computer is taking the plane to the various waypoints that have been programmed in for this particular flight.
Runway 26 left approach,
So I've been cleared to 19,000 feet, so I'm going to put that in. Yes. Okay. I will expedite my ascent to 190. So there's the Thames estuary, the River Thames. Oh, the air traffic control's really busy, isn't it? So we're heading towards Kent. And we're going to be heading towards Dover. Kent is where my brother lives. My brother lives in Broadstairs in Kent, which is near Margate. There is an airfield there, Kent International Airport. It's called Manston. And it's worth a visit, actually, because they've got some good war memorabilia there. There's a Spitfire and a Hurricane and lots of other interesting stuff as well. So you can see Manston coming up here. Manston is Echo Golf Mike Hotel EGMH. So we're going to be passing fairly near Manston. Well, that looks pretty nice, doesn't it? Nice, pretty pretty. Very pretty. Pretty, pretty. I've been cleared to flight level 310, 31,000 feet now, which would be my cruising altitude. So we can put 31,000 feet now into the altitude bug.
Boeing 758, did you copy? 6002.
Yes, I did copy.
Flight heading 290, proceed on course. Descend and maintain flight level 260.
Climb and maintain flight level 310. Boeing 758.
So there we go.
Turn right, heading 290.
Climbing again now to 31,000 feet. We can watch the navigation computer working with this readout. We're tracking along here. The line, the white line there, will turn magenta or pink, if you want to call it pink. And when it turns pink, the aircraft will automatically follow that track. It will bank to the left and follow the track. So that's what the nav hold switch is doing. It's following the navigation that's been programmed into the computer. Yeah, doing a good job, I reckon. So far.
Swiss 486, turn right, heading 310.
I've tried to make it look as pretty as I can as well. The evening flight. See if we can see Manston. If you can see just through those two clouds there, the airport down there, that's Manston, or Kent International Airport. and Broadstairs, where my brother lives, is roughly around here, where the mouse is, and Margate is a little bit further around there. So let's watch this track on the navigation computer. As soon as this turns to a magenta colour, the aircraft will bank to the left, and it's now going to follow that track. Down there, that's Dover. So we're just leaving the English coast now, passing over Dover, and we'll be crossing the channel. It's only a short crossing here, and overflying Dunkirk in France. And then, pretty soon after that, we'll be going into Belgium.
Descend and maintain 4000. Swiss
486. So we can increase the speed now a little bit. We've got up to 280 knots now. Could have done that earlier, actually. So our ground speed at the moment is 380 miles per hour. Although we're reading 248 knots airspeed. I like how you can see the actual reflection of the clouds in the water. It's really cool. Hi Bill, nice to see you on the stream anyway. Yeah, it's a bit difficult, Bill, really, because my co-pilot is in Germany. Okay, over to Paris Center.
126.475, Boeing 758. Paris Center, Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758, is at flight level 291, climbing flight level 310.
Boeing, Romeo, Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758, Paris Center.
Hi, David. Okay, that's fair enough. Yeah, got room for a hitchhiker. You were hiding in the toilet, David, weren't you, all that time? You're only coming out now because I can't do anything about it, because I can't go round, you know, turn back, basically. As you can see, we're well out across the channel now. And there's Dunkirk up ahead. So, Okay, over to Brussels Center now.
125.0, Boeing 758. Brussels Center, Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758 is at flight level 300, climbing flight level 310. Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot, Romeo 758, Brussels Center, roger.
I put the wrong altitude in, it's 31,000 feet, 30,000 feet, whoops, no problem. That's fine. I downloaded the flight plan from the internet, and you can download various pretty true-to-life flight plans, and the one I downloaded from Stansted to Hahn, I checked it out, and it is virtually the same as the one that I fly in real life. You can modify it anyway, that's no problem. But all the waypoints seem the same, because I definitely fly over Dunkirk when I do this flight, and I definitely fly over Brussels and Liege, which is what we're going to be doing as well. So a pretty true to life flight plan, even though the flight the actual piloting might not be true to life. But so there we have Dunkirk below us now, and further down the coast, which we can't see, I think it's Calais, isn't it? And I think Ostend is a little bit further in that direction, if my geography serves me right. Anyway, hopefully the stream's holding out okay. Of course, you're getting it in 720p, and I've got it in full HD, of course, but hopefully you can read some of the instruments, maybe. There's a few little bugs I still have on FSX. Steam Edition FSX is so much better than the other. It seems to be much more stable, but I still get a few little bugs cropping up from time to time. Sometimes the actual zoom, freezes, and I can't zoom at all. That's why I'm going to leave it set as it is, because sometimes the actual zoom doesn't work. Changing our track now, just slightly, going towards the next waypoint. Another odd little things happen, but you know, it's a 10-year-old game, so I think you know, for its age, it's doing pretty good. A lot of the freeware I use in FSX is actually installed, and I do use a lot of freeware, but I also use some payware as well, and it all seems to work in the Steam Edition. Yeah, okay, David. Yeah, you've done the... I really ought to do the journey by car. I was just chicken out. Sylvia would like me to actually do the journey by car to Germany. And all the time I've been going over, which is about 10 years now, I've relied on air transport. I flew from Bristol to begin with. Then they stopped flying to Germany from Bristol. I don't think Bristol were very happy about that. Lufthansa were flying from Bristol, or rather it was called Eurowings, which is a little subsidiary of Lufthansa, and they packed that up after about 18 months, so then I had to find another way of getting over there. So I ended up going to Stansted Airport, journeying up from the West Country. It's quite a way to go, but that's what I've been doing. I flew first of all to Zweibrücken, which is fairly near to where Sylvia lives, but then Ryanair pulled out of that airport, and so then I started going to Frankfurt Hahn, which is this journey here. But they're not doing so many flights now to Frankfurt Hahn, and typical Ryanair, I think they sort of, you know, find the best place, and quite often they'll up sticks. It looks like Frankfurt Hahn is in for a hard time. I hope Ryanair are going to continue to fly there, but they've cut their flights right back. When I fly to Germany now, I actually fly to Luxembourg, and then I get picked up from Luxembourg by Sylvia. It's a shorter journey from Luxembourg to where I need to go, actually, so it's probably a better place to fly to. So check how things are going here. Everything looks okay. Cruising at 31,000 feet. Of course, we're travelling away from the sun, aren't we? So the sun is going to appear to set quicker than normal. Flying in the opposite direction to the setting sun. So we'll be flying over Brussels shortly. Not too far to go. Yeah, David's explaining about getting on the ferry. I mean, it's something I could do. I don't know if I could make this. Cause the thing is, I don't do that much driving anymore since I've been going to Germany. Since I've been going to Germany for the last 10 years, basically. Sylvia's done all the driving when we've been in Germany. I mean, I come back every month or so and to check on my mother, and I'm here for, you know, 4 or 5 weeks, something like that, and I do a little bit of driving, but nothing much. I used to do loads of driving. But anyway, perhaps I'm just making an excuse. No, today is not the day for the ferry. You're right, David. Absolutely not. I should have put the real world weather into the flight simulator. Stick the real world weather in. I probably would have, failed to take off. Wouldn't have been able to see anything at all anyway because of the cloud cover. And blimey, the crosswind landing at Hahn would have been quite bad. I don't know if the wind is as bad in Germany as it is here. If it's not, it probably will be in about a day's time. We normally get the same weather, or similar weather to us, about a day later. So we must be at least halfway through the flight now, I guess. You see Brussels coming up. Yeah, I can just see my display for the stream, the video display is to be working okay. Hopefully you're all seeing the stream okay. So here's Here's Brussels, Echo Bravo Bravo Romeo. So we're flying virtually over the smack bang over Brussels. So there's Brussels below. And there's the airport below, just above the plane there. It's Brussels Airport down there. When I flew to Luxembourg last flight, it was a very clear evening and it was really great looking outside of the plane. Really, really nice. We don't often get that. Often there's the cloud cover is pretty bad. But it is really nice, isn't it, if you're in the plane and you can sort of look out, there's not too many clouds about and the visibility is good. You can see all those lights down there, it's really, really great. I like that. Well, my video monitor for the stream was completely frozen, so hopefully the stream is working. I'm sure it's just my Wi-Fi or something. I'm still getting the chat, I think.
2822, turn left, heading 125, proceed on course.
Turn left, heading 125, proceed on course. 2822.
We'll be flying over Liege. How do you pronounce that? I don't know. Is that right, Liege? Bet your life Silvio pronounces it completely different to what I do.
Bird Niner 46, contact Amsterdam Center on 119.175.
So, goodbye Brussels. Thanks, David. Okay, good. As long as the stream's okay. The Ryanair livery was it was a free download as well. It's a 737 livery pack, so I put that on just to get the default 737 in Ryanair livery. I really ought to shell out and get the PMDG version of the 737 with every system works. You've got to do everything by the book then, haven't you? But I'm sort of an intermediate flight simmer. I mean, I'm not deadly serious, but I like a little bit of authenticity, but I'm sort of somewhere in the middle. So I don't do that many flights using flight sim, but I do enjoy it. I've been doing more train sim lately. I think next stream I do will definitely be train sim again, I think. Liège, there we go. Or could it be Liège or Liège? Liège. Liège? Liège. Thanks, David.
Boeing 758, descend and maintain
some more traffic over there. Sort of flying parallel to us. Right, I've been told to descend, haven't I? Right. Down to 19,000 now. So starting our descent. So we're putting 19,000 in to the autopilot. And we can bring the speed back now to 250 knots for the descent.
4-9-2, contact Amsterdam Center on 119.175.
Co-pilot's just put on some different lights on the panel by the look of it. Suffering from stinging eyes, a bit of eye strain or something.
3306, contact login center on 118.75. 118.75 for 3306.
See that other traffic up there, sort of. Another aircraft up there running parallel with us, higher altitude. Right, something I can do, I can bring up the radio panel if it works. Sometimes this doesn't work either. Well, I did that time. Bring that over there. I can put in the ILS frequency, the instrument landing frequency. I know what runway I'm going to be landing on, and I know the frequency. So if we go to navigation radio and I put in 111.3, that's the instrument landing system frequency at Frankfurt Hahn. Click this button so when it becomes active I get a Morse code ident. So I should put it over to the active. So that's 111.3. So that's put into the radio, into the navigation radio now.
Turn right, heading 340, Swiss 770.
But that won't work unless I put this little switch here from GPS to nav. But since I'm still following the GPS flight plan, that's got to stay on GPS at the moment. So there's Liège or Liège. So we're descending to there we are, just tracking towards another waypoint now that's in the flight plan. We're descending to 19,000 feet.
2-8-2-2.
And it won't be long until we're crossing into Germany. Okay, we've been told to head 095, so we're...
Turn left, heading 065.
065, changed his mind. So we're being vectored now by air traffic control.
Turn left, heading 065.
So I've put that in. So nav hold switch now comes off. And we go to navigation there, and we click... Don't turn to the... no, it always does that. That's strange, isn't it? It sort of kicks over to the right when we're going to turn left. So we're going to be turning now to 065. So we're going to be under the control of the air traffic control now.
Boeing 758, please expedite your turn to heading 065.
Yeah, I am. Just because I was a little bit late doing it, doesn't mean I'm not doing it. You do get towed off, don't you, pretty quickly by the ATC, the FSX ATC. 065, you said, and that's where I'm going. So, air traffic control has us in its capable hands, and we're descending to 19,000 right now. So I would say we're probably just about crossing into Germany. Right to 090. The other thing about the ATC, once they start giving you vectors, sometimes they don't quite make sense because they sort of make you do these tiny... They make you do these very small changes that sometimes... They're a bit crazy. Oh, what have I got to descend to? I didn't get that.
Turn right, heading 090, descend and maintain 900,000.
Right.
758.
9,000 feet now, down to 9,000.
A lot of people... 758, contact Longyear Center on 118.75.
God, it's getting busy in here, isn't it? Different center now.
118.75 for Boeing 758.
Langen Center.
Langen Center, Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot Romeo 758 is out of flight level 180 for 900,000. Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot Romeo 758, Langen Center, Roger. Altimeter 29052.
Okay. Yeah, the air traffic control can give you sort of vectors. It keeps changing its mind. But I like the air traffic control. I think it's more immersive with it. A lot of people don't use it at all, but I quite enjoy it. Apologies about, if anybody is asking me anything in chat or saying, I think I've got a problem with my Wi-Fi, I'm monitoring the actual stream on Wi-Fi, so apologies if I'm not getting certain things that anyone's saying. The video's been froze for a long time now, but anyway, I think the stream is working. That's the main thing. Okay, Bill. Yeah, I don't saw I could do him any loops with this one. Great, you got the guitar boogie shuffle going. Actually, I was going to play some music, but oh, I forgot about that. It's a bit too late now. Things are going to get a bit hectic for me now. There are, the sun's disappearing now behind the clouds. This is a stressful time for me now. I'm going to be really busy in a minute. Acknowledge a handoff to another. So everything's looking good so far, weather looks good. I actually loaded in a weather theme that was part of FSX. As I said, I didn't want to do the real weather. And a nice spring evening as well. So it makes it look a little bit more pleasant, doesn't it? Bit more eye candy, so to speak. So well into Germany now. To check that I've got that frequency right, that's by memory, 111.3 for the ILS instrument landing system.
755 is at 8,600, descending 6,000. 755, wintering approach, roger, altimeter 2952.
The engine's coming up now as we're leveling out. Leveling out at 9,000 feet.
Boeing 758, turn right heading 120.
Right heading 120. So acknowledge that.
Turn right heading 120, Boeing 758. Boeing 758, turn left heading 0905. Boeing 758, turn left heading 0905. Descend and maintain 5,000.
Down to 5,000 now.
Boeing 758, please acknowledge.
Sir.
Turn left heading 0905, descend and maintain 5,000, Boeing 758.
Telling me off again.
Boeing 758, turn right heading 120.
Right to 120. This thing that it does, lots of little course corrections, but it's very clever, isn't it, how it sorts everything out. Good. We're getting to answer air traffic control here. Do you know what? I never even put the fasten seatbelt sign off, did I? I do it for the last 10 minutes of the journey. I probably forget to put it on again. Oh dear. Another plane over there with lights.
758, traffic is 2 o'clock, 4 miles, at 6,000, airbus A319, report them in sight. 755, traffic is 1 o'clock, 4 miles, at 5,000.
I saw that traffic.
Boeing 737, report them in sight. Boeing 758, have the traffic. 755, turn right, heading 015.
There's the ident for the ILS.
Turn right, heading 015, 755.
So I'm going to turn that ident off.
Boeing 737 in sight.
You can see now that the localizer is coming through, which is this little magenta triangle there. So that's the part of the ILS system, so we're picking that up now. Okay, we've been vectored now
on tower, Boeing,
towards
Romeo
the runway.
Romeo 758 is
contact the tower.
North inbound ILS runway 21 approach. Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot Romeo 758 on tower. Fly straight in runway 21 altimeter 2952. Make straight in runway 21 Boeing 758.
Okie dokie, so we need to slow down a bit now. So we'll bring the speed down. And we put the fasten seatbelt sign on again. And we can get prepared for landing now. Lights on. We have to start putting some flap down. Have to arm the speed brake like that. The glide slope has come alive now. That's the glide slope, we're below it, which is where we should be. So I bring the landing gear down now. A little bit more flat. Bring the speed down a little bit more. We want about 140 knots for landing. Continue bringing the flap down. Right, now I'm going to go from heading select to nav hold Sorry, approach hold. Now the autopilot is going to trap the ILS. Left that slightly too late, but we should be fine. Now the autopilot will trap the ILS now into Hahn. So you can see there's the there's Hahn, EDFH. And the autopilot now is going to follow the glide slope and the localizer. This might be a good job because there's a lot of cloud around here. So what we'll probably do is just put the heading to the runway direction, because in case we have to go around or something. Can't see a lot in this cloud. So the speed is roughly 114 knots, which is okay. Speed brakes are armed, gears down. What else have I got to do? Lights are on, landing lights. I think that's about it. So, final approach to Hahn. Yeah, we'll probably get a lot of terrain pull up in a minute. No sight of the runway yet. Oh, there it is. Just can't see any lights. You can see it in the distance there. So you see we're tracking the ILS now pretty good. While the autopilot is. So all's looking good there. Getting serious now. You're right, hold on. Okay. Oh, by the way, did I tell you there's something wrong with my joystick? It's not really working right, it's all over the So here we have Frankfurt Hahn dead ahead. Used to be an American airbase, Frankfurt Hahn, so it's
2500.
It's typical Ryanair. That's the radio altimeter now, which is calling out the actual height above ground. The used to be an American airbase, typical Ryanair airport, where they sort of, you know, everything they want to get is, they want it to be relatively cheap. And it's right out in the middle of nowhere. It really is quite. It's not a difficult place to get to, but the weather's always quite bad. That's the problem. Right, clear to land.
Clear to land, runway 21, Boeing 758.
Yeah, so it's all, especially this time of year, it's a bit touch and go with the weather. It's often pretty foggy. And, but I've, you know, ever since I've been going there, I have managed to get there. There's never been a flight that's been cancelled. Although I've had a few hairy landings there when it's been ice and snow about. Right, reverse thrust is something I always forget. That's F2, isn't it? And the speed brakes are armed. They deploy automatically now. I haven't put auto brakes on, so I'll just brake manually. No excuses accepted. So it'll probably take it down about 1,000 feet, turn off
1,
the
auto,
turn off the autopilot, and autopilot's come off now. Can we get a little bit nearer, we'll turn off the auto throttle as well, but the auto throttle can manipulate things a lot better than what I can.
500. 400. 300. 200.
Take the auto throttle off.
100. Minimums 50, 40, 30, 20, 10.
And the reverse thrust is coming on. A little bit off the center. Manual brakes. Auto thrust comes off.
Boeing 758, exit runway when able.
Hooray! It wasn't too bad. So we'll bring the flaps up now. Clean up the aircraft, as they say. And here we are, welcome to Frankfurt Hahn, which is, this is some scenery by Aerosoft and is modeled really great. Exactly how,
758, turn next taxiway.
Exactly how the, how it is,
Boeing
amazing.
758, contact ground on 121.975.
So, contact ground.
121.975, Boeing 758.
Taxi to the gate and request that.
Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot Romeo 758, request taxi to the gate.
Boeing Romeo Yankee Foxtrot Romeo 758, taxi to gate Bravo 4, using taxiway Delta Alpha.
Bravo 4.
Taxiing to gate Bravo 4, using taxiway Delta Alpha, Boeing 758.
The landing lights. Bravo 4, that's not a usual position to park for this flight, I must say. It's usually Alpha something. Don't think I've ever parked in flight sim Bravo, but I guess it's just a little bit further down the taxiway. So there's Alpha. Bravo must be a little bit further down. So thanks for joining me on my little flight. I had some fun. I've got a nice gaming computer now in Germany as well, so I can play Flight Simulator in Germany now. It's brilliant. Right, this is Bravo. Bravo 4, it said, I think, didn't it? awkward to get around here, isn't it? Bravo 3. Bravo 5. Have I missed it? Not sure. Have I gone past it? Perhaps it was the first one. Bravo 5, Bravo 2, was it down here? Whoops. Oh no, here it is, right at the bottom here. Bravo 5, Bravo 4. There's a Ryanair plane there with the old livery, slightly different, well, same livery, but different writing on the thing. It's an older one. Well, older plane, I guess. Okay, well, parking brake is on then, cut the engines, let's start the APU actually, haven't I? Should have done that before, whoops, never mind. So, there we are. Take off some of these lights, aren't these on anymore? Oh, let's turn off everything. Let's go to bed. So there we are, arrived at Frankfurt Hahn. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the stream. And as I say, I don't normally get off at Bravo. I'm usually further up the other end. But as I say, it's only a small airport, but it's a Ryanair hub, so there's always Ryanair planes here. I think Wizz Air fly out of there. I think Sun Express or something like that, but only very small airlines. The main organisation that fly from Hahn is Ryanair. So, thanks for watching. See you all again. See you on anybody that watches Matt on Train Sim Live. I'll see you there. And we'll probably do a stream for Train Simulator next time. Cheers all, thanks for watching.